Hello everybody and welcome back to Minecraft Biome Survival. This is episode 51 and I am playing in the rarest biome in the game, Modified Jungle Edge, aka Jungle Edge M. And it's basically a hilly version of Jungle Edge. As you can see, it's definitely not flat. There's a big mountain over there. And I am playing in snapshot 20W22A. So yeah, we're gonna do the classic find the diamonds and such. Unlike last episode, this one's like all natural, you know. Last one I kind of had some fun with it, changed things up a bit, but this is back to the regular kind, and I did not pick the best tree to get stuff from. So yeah, it's just gonna be an average episode, and after this one, we have one more, and then we'll get on to the new nether biomes, starting in episode 53. So, should be an interesting time when 1.16 comes out, which hopefully it'll be out by the time I need to record those episodes, because this is still a monthly series, and the episodes should be going up at the beginning of each month. So at this rate, August will be when those episodes come out. But who knows? I might do the first one earlier just to kind of get a start with the nether stuff. But for now, we still have this one, and next episode is going to be the Bamboo Jungle Hills. I think I might have mentioned that one was planned already. And I have a specific order for all of the nether biomes set already too. I don't have the thumbnails made yet though, so it could still be subject to change. I don't remember the order off the top of my head, but I have it somewhere. But for now, we're going to be worrying about the Jungle Edge M, which has been requested a few times, but again, I've got all of these scheduled, so chances are whatever biome that you want to see has either already been done or will be done soon. So yeah, I'm getting notifications for things. So alright. So it seems food is plentiful already. I'm a bit distracted at the moment. But yeah. Hopefully, I see caves over there, so this might be pretty easy, but I said this in the normal Jungle Edge episode, which was a heck of a long time ago, but this is like my favorite biome. It just looks really cool, and if you're playing a normal world, you know, this is like a transition biome. It's between plains and jungle, I believe, so you don't really see this in its full glory unless you make a custom world like this. So this would be an interesting thing to like play a UHC in, or just do some sort of custom map type thing. I mean, for SMPs you'd really need more than one biome, but if you wanted to do like a limited event thing, I think this would be a pretty good way to go. I did one of the old sibling rivalry UHCs in one of these, and That was a pretty fun one. But yeah, alright. I think I'm probably good with trees by now, yeah. Alright. So let's do this. I always have trouble with commentary with these videos. I just don't really know what to talk about. Maybe we could talk about like the snapshots or something. I think so. By the time this video is released, snapshot 23, week 23, that should be released. Maybe, I have no idea. But because this current one that I'm playing in 22 was released late, so you never know. But I'm thinking that 1.16 is on the verge of being released, just because they're not really adding big stuff anymore. Like, they were adding, like, you know, the bastions, the biomes, the mobs, and all that. But now it's just kind of like technical stuff and bug fixes mostly. So I'm thinking that 1.16 is just around the corner. But who knows? But I, at this point, I don't think that really big new stuff is going to be added, but I could be wrong. But I'm probably not the only person who's kind of theorized this. But hopefully I succeed in this one, because I've had a big failure streak lately. I think... Wait, hold on. Do baby sheep just spawn? That must be a new thing. I didn't know they did that. I didn't know baby animals could just spawn. I know they did in Pocket Edition, or I think it's called Bedrock Edition now, which I haven't played in years, but I think that was a thing on there. I don't know what Bedrock Edition has now, but... And yet, you know, the good thing about this biome is that melons are really easy to find, and they make for a good food source, because one factor that I always have trouble with is finding enough food, because usually I kind of forget that. I kind of take the food for granted in Minecraft, because, I mean, even on Unknown Empire, I'm like, what food should I make today? Although, it's on that server, it's like golden carrots and stuff, like, you know, rich people business. Alright, let's kill this dude, and hopefully not die in the process. Ooh, there's a spider in there. Let's not deal with that quite yet. Okay. Well, wait, maybe we will. We're gonna take the spider out like a boss. I hear zombie villager as well. So this cave might go deep. Maybe. Well, there's something under it at the very least. So let's just get some coal and maybe we'll dig down a bit. The thing with these biomes is that, or this series, I spend a lot of time in the caves, but the world mostly looks the same. This one kind of varies a bit. Like, I find that with the... when a terrain is, like, either really flat or really dense, it's kind of the same, but when it's, like, just the right balance, like this, it's kind of different depending on where you go. So... could be an interesting. There's no structures, I don't think, especially since it's like a modified terrain biome, because those never have anything different. Hello. Oh, this guy's a jungle villager. Oh shoot. Oh, I'm gonna burn to death. Let's not. Okay, well, one hit from that zombie villager really did a number on me. See, once a month I have to go back to stage one of Minecraft world, where it's just stone tools and no armor, because the rest of the time I'm so used to having, like, fully enchanted diamond stuff, and I probably say that every time, too. I don't really go back and watch these, but actually, let's do what I do other times and put the food in my offhand. So, I'm thinking we got everything we need on the surface. I don't think there's much else that I require up here. So, now what I have to do is just find iron and such. And then the diamonds. Oh, I miss Optifine in Biome Survival. It made caving a lot easier with dynamic lighting. Oh, there's some. There we go. I'm gonna need more stone. Too, which I'm sure I'll find, because I guarantee you'll have to be digging around for diamonds. I don't remember, well, I know last episode is when I was going through that mansion and outrunning mobs and somehow surviving quite a while. I didn't survive the whole episode. I ended up getting swarmed by vexes and evokers and stuff, and there was really no way to escape that, but I, like, destroyed a ton of vindicators and stuff. So, I got a lot farther last episode than I thought I would. And it was permanite. It was complete eternal darkness. So, yeah, I think I did pretty well getting as far as I did with last time. But now I'm going to try and go for success because I think it's possible. The main challenge is just finding diamonds because I am by no means a good caver. I can never manage to find much of anything. It takes a really long time, which is probably why I don't do a lot of SMPs. I don't know how I got where I did on Unknown Empire. But yeah. The Traveler's Origin series, I don't know. I don't even think the server has been up in like a month or so. So I'm kinda, I really lost interest in that one, I'm not gonna lie, I'm kinda done with it. And plus it's outdated. I mean, it was stuck in this one snapshot before the bastions were put in. So yeah, there's not really much that I want to do with that, but for all the other people who are up for that, you know, you do you. The Ender Dragon's already been slain, like, ages ago, so yeah. But that's fine, you know, it's... I guess the Unknown Empire one, it's not, like... I mean, it's vanilla, but it's got, like, story and custom terrain and stuff. And I guess that's what I like about it, because even before I knew about the story stuff, because I didn't know about that until I was well into making the series, but I did know about the custom terrain, and I did not expect to do all the building stuff that I did, but it's definitely probably my favorite thing to record at the moment. But for Biome Survival, I have battle pants, so we're good to go. I am going to need more iron. I should have made a pickaxe. Oh well. Battle pants are good too. So, what level is this? 42? I still got a ways to go. Maybe I'll... Thing is that I'm stuck in all this gravel, so... Yeah. Get out of that, and then we can do... We can get some stuff done. But yeah, this is kind of... the boring part of the episode, where I'm just digging around trying to find diamonds. And what I usually do is cut stuff out that's boring like this, because let's face it, my commentary is no good and you guys don't want to see me dig around forever, so yeah. I might just do that. I might just cut until I find something. Okay, so I've been digging for a little bit and I heard lava somewhere. I did turn on subtitles because I kind of need them. But yeah, I have never really used these before, so yeah, but I heard, yeah, I think the lava's this way. Oh, and there's water, so there's a cave somewhere, like right here, and hopefully this cave will have diamonds. There it is. Okay, this is the cave. Now, I'm sure I already know the answer. I'm sure there's actually nothing in here, but on the off chance that there is, that would be pretty good, but it doesn't look like there is, which is unfortunate. But I'm gonna go back and get this iron. Okay. So let's just empty out some of this clutter. And I suppose a bucket would be good. Bucket of water, okay. There we go. Alright, so unfortunately, this doesn't really seem to have anything of value inside. But we can look. I just need one measly diamond ore. That does not look good. Okay, this thing is a problem. I wonder if this... if this goes somewhere. Oh, is that a ravine? It's definitely something beyond this tiny cave. This is a ravine. If anything's gonna have diamonds, it's gonna be this. But I could also very easily die by a creeper falling on my head, so I have to be careful. Here's the gold. It's not what I need or want, though. See, it's always whatever you are looking for, it's what you're not gonna find. It's just... there. Okay. Yep, there are zombies falling down all around me. And I'm still only wearing battle pants, by the way. There's another ravine right here. Oh my gosh! The diamonds, they're right there. Okay. There we are! Wow. I didn't think it would be that easy. I thought I would have to do a lot more searching in this cave, but this episode is, in fact, a... Hold on. Hold on. It's a success. There we go. Full inventory. But it is a success. And how many did we get? We got 7. And you know what that means? With 7 diamonds, we could easily upgrade the battle pants to a nice blue shade. There we go. Completely unused, too. Well, now they're burned. But I now have some shiny diamond battle pants. And that is it for this episode. I hope you guys enjoyed. And next episode will be the last one before the nether stuff. So hopefully by the time August rolls around, 1.16 will be ready, but I'm sure it will be, because why wouldn't it? But as for episode 51, this is goodbye.